difference you've seen?
Well, like what Coach Kelly said, you know, we're going to do whatever it takes to win. We're going to go out there. You know, it doesn't matter what team we're playing. You know, we're going to do whatever it takes to win.
Miles, you mentioned kind of not necessarily jitters because you're too far out, but what's the focus been like this week in practice? You know, with everything that is on the line, is there that extra added step maybe in terms of the way guys are preparing?
Yeah, it's just more, you know, fine-tuning the little details. You know, obviously, not this past week, but last week, you know, we're working more on, you know, skill development, you know, just getting back to the swing of things after having, you know, a week off. So now we've just been, you know, fine-tuning, you know, our game plan and, you know, getting back in sync with quarterbacks and stuff like that.
Is there a certain level of, I know you said you're not nervous about how you'll handle it, but is there a certain level of anticipation and to get to the game, and just how do you manage that as players?
Me personally, I honestly try not to think about it until the game is there. You know, I've always been taught, you know, the game is won before the game is actually played. So if I focus on my preparation and everything I got to do, then it'll all come to me. You know, I'm an extremely patient person, and I don't get over anxious about too many things.
Miles, there's been a lot of talk about the pass rush of Clemson and obviously the matchup between their defensive line and your offensive line, but for you guys as receivers, how much does knowing that they have a solid pass rush mean that you have to be on your job to make sure you're getting open quicker?
Yeah, we understand, you know, obviously with their pass rush that, you know, Ian's going to have to get the ball up quickly. And when the ball comes out quickly, you know, it can be anywhere. You know, he doesn't have time to be, you know, perfect like he has been all season. So that just means we got to be perfect on the outside. We got to go up and make plays for him and take care of business.
Chase Claypool's improvement seems like the last, maybe post-bye, the last five or six games, he really seemed to join you in Fink, where it was instead of one week really good, he's just been ascending and heavy. What have you seen? Have you seen anything noticeable where he just became a more consistent player?
Yeah, it's his focus. You know, when Chase comes to focus, he's tough. He's a tough guy to stop. I mean, he's every bit of 6'5", you know, 230. He's huge, and obviously you've seen how physical he is on special teams. But, yeah, when Chase's focus is there, there's no one in the country that can stop him.
What does that do for the receiving core? Because it seems that when it's just two, it's a little bit easier to account for, but the three of you plus a tight end seems to stretch defenses.
Yeah, it elevates us, you know, 100%. You know, it's tough. It's tough to cover teams that have two receivers, let alone three, and, you know, a great tight end, obviously.
When there's a quarterback change, that can be emotional and tough for a locker room. What stood out to you when you think back to that time, and why it hasn't been something that's deterred you guys a whole lot?
I think one of the reasons why we handle it so well is because we kept the emotion out of it. You know, we understand that, you know, we're playing a game, and our goal is to win a national championship, and we're going to do whatever it takes. So, you know, as a receiver, our approach didn't change one bit. You know, we were out there, we ran routes the same way, and we worked the same way, and it didn't matter who was throwing us the ball.